Eli nyt ollaan täällä Tampereen lentoasemalla ja tultiin taksilla täältä Tampereen keskustassa, ajettiin tänne Pirkkalaan. Ja on kyllä rupeen jännitystiivistymään ihan hirveästi jännittää päästä esimerkiksi susikeskukseen. Ja tässä vielä odotellaan muutama tunti ja sitten päästään koneeseen. Ja nyt näyttää lentokeliikin vähän paremmalta. Joo, eli nyt tultiin tänne Dörverten susikeskukseen ja päivä on ollut pitkä, mutta lento oli yllättävänkin mukava ja henkilökunta koneessa oli tosi ystävällisiä, mukavia ja ymmärtäväisiä, kun otettiin kuvia ja videonpätkää. Ja sittenhän se meni vähän hektisesti, sieltä lähdettiin ratikalla ja junalla sitten tänne Dörverteniin. Nyt rupeaa pikkuhiljaa tuntumaan, että kun koko päivä on jännittänyt tätä tulemista tänne, niin nyt rupeaa olemaan aika kuitti ja pitää varmaan lähteä nukkumaan, että sitten että huomenna päästään tosi toimia kuvaamaan tyttöä, sudet, hommaa, dokumenttia eteenpäin. Tässä on nyt hyvin nukuttu yö takana ja rupeaa aamun valkenemaan täällä susikeskuksella ja lähdetään aamupalalle kohta. Ja yö oli varsin mielenkiintoinen. Itse en kyllä kuullut yhtään mitään, mutta sudet oli ulvonut ihan mahdottomasti. Ja tästä se sitten päivä rupeaa taas valkenemaan ja keli on kylmä, mutta näillä mennään. Ja kohta lähdetään sitten tosi toimi.
Good morning.
Hallo, morning.
My new colleague is here.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah. Hey. Hey Sara, nice to meet you.
Yeah, nice to meet you too. I'm really looking forward to see the Wolfcenter.
Yeah, so let's make a walk around and have a look to everything.
Yeah, nice.
So, come in.
Thank you.
Okay. So I have to put the electrical wire on the side. So, come in. Yes, we have to repair. This is this is a location where the wolves can pick up water, drink water.
Yeah.
But as you see, we have to repair the pool here in this area. We have to put more water in.
Yeah.
Because they try to examine the pool's construction. Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. They are very curious.
Of course.
Yeah.
So
you can see some wolves
there
on the other side of this enclosure.
Yeah.
So let's say hiding away from us. But on the other hand, they are sometimes very curious. And there is one young wolf. He's 3 years old.
Yeah.
He's sometimes very interested.
Yeah, there is one.
This is Levi.
Yeah.
And his brother Mitya is the wolf I talked about.
Yeah, he's coming here.
Which might be very curious in coming 6-7 meters to us. We will see.
So how near they usually
come? It depends from the individual. So Mitya and Levi are the wolves who show themselves in a distance of, let me say, 6-8 meters.
Yeah.
But the old wolves named Oblomov and Antoshka,
yeah,
they are very shy is not the correct word,
but they will
keep they are very careful.
Yeah,
they look and they check up the situation. What do the people here inside the enclosure, and so this is very similar to the real behavior in the freedom, in the nature.
Okay. Yeah.
Because I do not believe that wolves feel frightened with respect to us as humans.
Yeah, that's true.
I do not believe this, but I believe they do not want to be in touch with us because we are not prey for the wolves.
Yeah.
So, yeah. And therefore they are sometimes looking what are doing the people over there and go their own way away.
Yeah.
The most important thing to know with respect to these four wolves in this enclosure is that all of them are not hand-raised by humans.
Yeah.
So this means these wolves are raised by other wolves, as in freedom.
Yeah.
So this is a normal situation. A wolf couple is educating their own puppies.
Yeah, just and like in nature.
Like in the nature, yeah.
Yeah.
And due to this reason, these wolves are not interested in us, I said. But over there, you can see a wolf. This is Levi.
Yeah.
So he doesn't feel frightened, as I said, but on the other hand, he is not interested in us.
Yeah.
So he's going his way. With respect to their behavior, they are very similar to wild wolves, but for sure, these wolves know visitors and employee stuff, and they adapted to this situation. So the fence is a kind of safety for the wolves, because the wolves know the visitors stay outside the enclosure, but we as staff are coming every day inside this enclosure,
So and they are used to that. As you, sometimes we have visitors.
Yeah.
Just a few here in this enclosure. And for sure the wolves know the situation as well.
Yeah.
Yeah. And they still keep in distance, as you say. They are not interested to come and say hello, how are you?
Yeah,
and
like so dogs.
Like a dog, yes, yeah. Correct. So, and but the wild wolves have the wish to have a bigger distance between themselves and us.
Yeah, this is another one.
Yeah, this is Mitya over there. And so in the wilderness sometimes wolves are curious as well.
Yeah.
Yes, when they are young, when they are puppies, they might be very curious and looking. Oh, a human, what's a human and what is he doing there?
Yeah.
And do he has a dog at the leash or not, and something like that.
Yeah.
Yeah. But they are not really interested in human related to prey.
Yeah. But he's coming closer.
Yeah.
And he's checking
looking. He's looking what we are doing here.
Yeah. He's a little bit curious.
Yeah. But I show you. Stay here.
Yes.
Yeah. Now you see he's hiding away.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And he knows you for a long time.
Even he's knowing me, exactly. So as you saw, I clapped my hands. I had a special Bondi language a few minutes ago when I go straight to Mitya.
Yeah.
And he hide away. So he's coming. But it's important to know, Mitya was 9 weeks old when he came into this enclosure from another zoo. And our old wolves, Oblomov and Antoshka, they were so the parents.
Yeah.
Right then. Respect to him.
Yeah.
And although he knows us now 3 years, he's 3 years old,
and
he is still, yeah, let me say, a kind of shy. Yeah. Not really shy, but he says, "Whoa, he's coming, let's go."
Yeah, and he's still keeping the distance to you.
Exactly. So. Exactly. Yeah. So, and when this wolf is behaving as we saw in this enclosure, he only knows this enclosure. So then I'm asking myself, how has to feel a wild wolf in the wilderness when he or it sees a human or a group of humans, they are going away.
Yeah.
But sometimes it's possible that the wolves are standing and looking, what is the man or the woman doing over there? And then he goes this way along. So, okay, schau mal, da oben ist er. Wir drücken ihn an der GoPro vorbei. Dazu müssen wir allerdings noch ein bisschen den Hügel, Vorsicht. Be careful. Ja. So. Okay, ein bisschen nachkommen. Die sollen an der GoPro noch vorbei, sind sie aber noch nicht. So, jetzt.
Oh, yeah.
Now you have your GoPro picture. Und den anderen drücken wir auch noch.
Is there another one?
Yeah, there's the second one. This was Levi and Mitya is standing. Sag mal, im unterhalb der GoPro.
Yeah, below the GoPro.
Mitya is standing below the GoPro now. So let's go this way. For sure, Mitya knows that we are here walking. But you will see in a couple of seconds that he will go away. Now he's running over there. And Oblomov is over there as well. Yeah.
So, yeah,
let's go this way.
Nyt ollaan täällä susiaitoksessa, täällä missä näitä aikuisia susia. Täällä on 4 sutta. on pari vanhempaa ja sitten pari nuorempaa ja vanhemmat on pitänyt koko ajan etäisyyttä, mutta nuoremmat on tullut sitten parinkymmenen metrin päähänkin kattelemaan. Ja tuossa justiinsa nähtiin, että vaikka me käveltiin läpi puskien, niin aina ne sudet vaan kiersi ja lähti pakoon sitten. Että ei niitä periaatteessa kiinnosta tulla ihmisen luokse ja tervehtimään. Että se on ihan jännittävää huomata, että mitenkä vaikka ne on Frankinkin tuntenut monta vuotta, niin silti ne sitten lähtee pois. Että ei ne rupea tulemaan lähelle. Ja. Seuraavaksi lähdetään sitten nuoria susia katsomaan pentuaitaukseen ja sinne niin.
Yeah, okay, Sara. Now we are in another enclosure.
Yeah.
And we have two wolf puppies in this enclosure. They are almost 4 months old.
Yeah.
Each. It's a male and a female. They are brothers and sisters. So their name is Dala.
Yeah.
She's a female. And Kimo, her brother.
Okay.
And these wolves are hand-raised by me and my colleagues.
Yeah.
And we have some practicals over there. They are all day long here in this enclosure because our wolves shall learn and build up a relationship to people.
Yeah.
So it's a big advantage to have hand-raised wolves because they do not feel shy or frightened with respect to all visitors.
Yeah.
And but now, as you can see, one of these wolves, and I'm sure the other one as well, is sleeping. And we have special rules with hand-raised wolves, so we do not wake them up.
Yeah.
And we do just a little bit education, so they are not allowed to bite us for sure.
Yeah.
But all other things are allowed.
Okay. Yeah.
So now you and me, we will go over to the wolves and we will see what they do or not. Look at these footprints. Yeah, they are very big.
Yeah.
Although they are just 4 months old, and these are not European grey wolves. These are Canadian wolves. They are named Hudson Bay wolves.
Yeah. How high will be?
Yes, they will be very high and will have a lot of mass.
Yeah.
In the next winter, so let me say in round about 4 months. They will have maybe their final weight and the height as well.
Yeah.
So I assume that the Kimo, the male, will have more than 50 kilograms. Yeah.
Well, that's
very
big
wolves. Yeah. So, and when you look at this footprint, German grey wolves have these footprint sizes when they are big. And he is a small puppy and has already now this size of a footprint, you know. So they will be big. So let's see what he's doing. Ah. Yeah. Hey. Yeah.
Oh, the other one is also there.
And the one and only reason that I am able to touch her is that these wolves are hand-raised by a milk bottle. When they were 2 weeks old, they came to us into this wolf center.
Yeah.
And we raised them by giving lots of milk, but lots of our body as well. Yeah, we spent 24 hours a day with them.
So they're really used to that.
During day and during night, and they used to get to know us more and more and more. Yeah, it's very, very interesting.
Yeah.
But it is very similar to be a father or a mother with a real human baby.
Yeah, in real life.
So
yeah.
You have lots of nights where you are not able to sleep. Yeah, you have to give food and to stay awake.
Yeah, but I think it's worth it.
Yeah. Huh? Ja. Ah, im Strecken. Aber das ist schon die Sache, ne?
Genau, hier mal in die Hocke, am Ort bleiben, sehr gut. Dann hat sie die Möglichkeit, sich anzunähern oder auch nicht, ne? Hey Mäuschen! They are totally different in their behavior with respect to humans. Exactly.
Yeah. Are you coming here?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah. And they like to lick your face. That's their way of saying hello.
Yeah.
Meet and greet, huh?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
So this is Dala.
Yeah.
This is Kimo. He is already bigger.
Yeah.
Than her.
Can you take a picture with me and the wolf?
Kimo.
Are you coming?
Yeah.
Yeah. Can you take a picture? Oh, yes.
Hmm? So already now they are bigger, some different kinds of usual dogs, yeah?
Yeah.
Small dogs, and already now they are big.
Yeah, I actually have this Caucasian Shepherd dog. So it's 16 weeks and it's also this big already.
Okay.
No niin, eli nyt tultiin tuolta nuorten susien tarhasta pois. Ihan käsittämätöntä, että mitenkä niinkö. Ne oli 4 kuukauden ikäisiä kanadalaisia. Kanadasta kotosi olevaa. Susi nuorukaisia, tosi sosiaalisia, tosi avoimia, ihan kuin koiranpentuja konsana ja eikä niinkö ihan totaalinen päinvastaisuus noille aikuisille susille. Ne jotka on kasvatettu ihan susien omasta toimesta verrattuna sitten näihin, jotka on käsiin kasvatettu ja ollut paljon sitten ihmisten kanssa tekemisissä. Ja Frank tuossa tosiaan kertoi, että nämäkin on ihan 9 viikkoisina tullut tänne ja on sitten siitä lähtien muutamat ensimmäiset viikot ihan niin kuin imetetty pullosta parin tunnin välein ja ihan 24/7 ollut vähän niin kuin omina lapsina ja ihan ei voi uskoa edes todeksi, että nyt on niin kuin ensimmäisen suteen koko elämäni aikana päässyt rapsuttelemaan ja sitten vaan matka jatkuu.
Yes, now we are here sitting in front of our wolf dog enclosure. These are Czech wolf dogs. They are not hybrids. They are usual dogs looking like wolves from their color, from their height and body mass. But as I said, they are usual dogs. On the other hand, they are a little bit special because it's a young category of dogs. So in 1955, these dogs were breeded in the Czech Republic. And first of all, they've been hybrids. But regarding to breeding rules, they got more and more real dogs. And here in Germany, it's forbidden to have hybrids in private houses. But these dogs, even they are young dog category, they are anyway nice dogs. And sometimes you can find these dogs in Germany at private persons. We have some breeders of these dogs here in Germany. And we have a second dog type looking similar to the Czech wolf dogs. And these dogs are named Zalos wolf dogs. And so there was a Dutch guy named Zalos, Mr. Zalos, and he produced, taking a German Shepherd and a wolf, he produced hybrids as well at first. But after then he started breeding dogs coming out of these hybrids, as the Czech guys did it as well with these dogs. And I suggest now to go into the enclosure and say hello to the dogs.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, so let's go.
So.
Yeah, they definitely look like
come
wolves.
Come in, quickly.
Yeah.
Close the door. First of all, so, this is our male. His name is Grauer. Grauer means a kind of gray. Yeah. His name is as he is looking like. Yeah. I like him. This is Ayuna.
Yeah.
Yeah. She's a female. Yeah. This is Wolfie.
Yeah.
She's a mixture. A shepherd, cross.
Yeah, you can Czech see wolf the dog. Brown
yes.
Coloring.
Huh? Yeah.
She wants scratching.
She likes to be touched.
Huh? Yeah, I can see that.
So. So, enough. Nope. Now it's enough. Grauer. Grauer. So I like this kind of dogs, and as you say, they are living in an enclosure.
Yeah.
And they know each other since years, and this is a good constraint for these dogs. On the other hand, it's okay to have these dogs at home, for example, but these dogs are very, they need their leader.
Yeah, so they are really loyal to one person. Also.
Yeah, they are very adapted to one person, and they are all individuals for sure. But sometimes you have an individual who wants to be with you all day long.
Yeah.
But if you have to work in a bureau outside, downtown, wherever, and you have to keep the dog at home, sometimes it might become very, special. Yeah?
So yeah.
The dogs are trying to follow you. And
yeah.
They can open doors or windows or something like that, and then it might be, difficult to handle these dogs. So these Czech wolf dogs, are real dogs, but in former times they were hybrids, and hybrids are not allowed in Germany at private persons because hybrids might be very varying from aggressive until very frightened.
Yeah.
But I'm sure there are many hybrids who are very nice animals, creatures.
Yeah.
But the German law says no, it's forbidden because we do not know about, all hybrids. Yeah? And we do not want to have these massive aggressive hybrids, hybrid dogs, And for this reason they are forbidden, and the handover from hybrid to dog takes different generations, and the rule in Germany says the fifth hybrid generation is allowed to be named dog and so on. And yes, and these are, in my opinion, these are very nice dogs.
Yeah.
But they are sometimes special dogs.
Yeah.
Eli nyt tultiin tuolta Tsekkoslovakian aitauksesta pois ja ihan oli käytökseltään koko pieniä koiranpentua, kun tuli nuolemaan naamaa ja hirveästi otti kontaktia ja tuli sitten rapsutettavaksi. Tykkäs olla sitten rapsutettavana aika ja hämmentävän paljon, niissä on hyvin paljon samaa kuin susissa ja liikkuu samalla tavalla kuin sudet ja hyvän kokoisiakin, niin ei tästä on taas ihan uskomaton päivä, ja tästä on hyvä jatkaa sitten myöhemmin.
Sie haben die Hoffnung, dass Sie noch was von meinem Mittagessen abbekommen? Mit 4 Jahren ist ein Wolf schon lange voll ausgewachsen. So sehen Wölfe in Deutschland aus. Das sind klassische europäische Grauwölfe. Den Wolf an sich, den gibt es in 13 verschiedenen Unterarten. Also bei Haustieren würde man von Rassen sprechen. Bei Wildtieren sind es die Unterarten. 13 verschiedene. Knurrt euch woanders an, nicht bei mir. 13 verschiedene gibt es hier bei uns, gibt es weltweit. Und dieser europäische Grauwolf, der ist im Vergleich zu den anderen Unterarten mittelgroß. Im Durchschnitt wird hier ein Wolf etwa 40 Kilo schwer. Die Rüden können bis zu 45 Kilo schwer werden. Die Feen, also die Wölfinnen, das hier ist die einzige Fee hier im Gehege, die liegen deutlich darunter. Das heißt, die werden so 30, 35 Kilo schwer. Und das sieht man denen natürlich dementsprechend auch an. Das heißt, sie sind sehr zierlich, der Kopf ist viel kleiner als von ihren männlichen Artgenossen. Und die Ilva, so heißt unsere Fee hier, die lebt hier mit ihren 5 Brüdern zusammen. Und das, was Sie hier jetzt sehen, das ist kein klassisches Rudel. Also 13 verschiedene Unterarten, das möchte ich nur noch einmal kurz beenden. Die größten und schwersten Wölfe, die es gibt, das sind die sogenannten Polarwölfe. Das sind ganz spannend, ne? Wölfe sind ziemlich schreckhafte Tiere, sehr vorsichtige Tiere. Alles, was sie nicht kennen und was irgendwie komisch ist in ihren Augen, das versetzt sie erstmal in Misstrauen. Da gehen sie erstmal auf Abstand. Wölfe kann man sehr leicht beeindrucken. Also die größten und schwersten Wölfe, die Polarwölfe, die können tatsächlich doppelt so schwer werden wie unsere. Bis zu 80 Norden hin automatisch größer und kräftiger. Ja, nun haben wir hier unsere einheimischen Wölfe. Die verhalten sich jetzt nicht so, wie man das eigentlich in freier Wildbahn erwarten muss. Diese Wölfe hier sind handaufgezogen. Das heißt, das sind Tiere, die wir schon... Oh, super, oder? Wie ein Vorstehhund. Tiere, die wir schon mit 10 Tagen aus einem anderen Tierpark zu uns geholt haben. Mit 10 Tagen ist ein Wolf noch gesehen. Und das war der Moment, als wir sie geholt haben, um sie hier vor Ort mit der Flasche großzuziehen. Das war für uns ganz wichtig, denn wir wollten gerne Wölfe haben. Ich möchte kurz dazwischen, ruhigbarer und sogar mitunter schädlich ist es für unsere Welpen nachher am Gehege. Das kann Epilepsie auslösen bei Welpen und auch bei Kleinkindern. Bitte beachten Sie das. Vielen Dank. So. Jetzt habe ich meinen Faden verloren. Das ist aber nicht schlimm, den kriege ich gleich wieder. Ja, wir haben die hier mit der Flasche großgezogen, weil es für uns ganz wichtig ist, Wölfe zu haben, die man gut sehen kann. Die, auch wenn große Menschengruppen hier sind, hier vorne häufig ihr Mittagsschläfchen haben. In unmittelbarer Nähe zum Menschen. Man hat sie immer vor Augen. Und für uns hier, die wir aufklären möchten über Wölfe, die... Also, das ist kein typisches Verhalten für Wölfe. Bin ich jetzt in freier Wildbahn unterwegs als Mensch und ich weiß, in Niedersachsen haben wir mittlerweile über 30 Wölfe und ich habe gerade gesehen, Wölfe sind ziemlich schreckhaft. Ich kann sie leicht erschrecken und beeindrucken, von Natur aus sehr vorsichtig. Was glauben Sie, wie groß ist die Wahrscheinlichkeit, mal so einen Wolf in freier Wildbahn zu begegnen?
5%.
Ich kann es gar nicht in Prozent. Bis jetzt sind die Begegnungen, wo das passiert ist, immer ohne Verletzungen, ohne Angriffe ausgegangen. Und tatsächlich ist es so, dass wir mittlerweile in Niedersachsen 4 richtige Rudel haben. Wölfe leben im Rudel. Normalerweise. Natürlich leben sie auch einzeln, bis sie einen Partner gefunden haben. Aber das klassische... Die klassische Familie des Wolfes ist das Rudel. Und Familie heißt Vater, Mutter plus die dazugehörigen Kinder. Und zwar aus den letzten beiden Jahrgängen. Das ist ein Rudel. Und ein Rudel besteht im Durchschnitt aus etwa tolle Beute, ne? Oh, Beute. Kommst gar nicht ran. Hm? Im Durchschnitt aus etwa 6 bis 10 Tieren. Und die Anführer in so einem Rudel sind immer die Eltern.
Yes, Sara, now we are inside our exhibition. So we have 2 exhibitions, but this is the one in the lower level. And yes, so this exhibition is asking who is the wolf? Yeah, what's his prey? What's his behavior? And in common, we are discussing all these questions within our guided tours. But beside the tours, it's very important for us to have exhibitions as well. So, for example, when we have rainy days and we cannot offer a guided tour, all our visitors have the chance to look here inside the exhibition and to see wolves as well, very close. And for example, the big deer here, and we have learn computers, so where you can get more details about wolves and the relations to prey and other things. And yeah, it's a nice exhibition from our point of view.
Yeah, it's really much details.
Yeah.
And you can really see how, for example, this wolf there,
yeah,
you can see the position where he is standing,
yeah,
and trying to hunt the deer.
Yeah. Yeah.
So. Los geht's.
Scharf, ne?
Ja.
Oh. Wenn sie einem die Haare kämmen, ne?
Hm?
Kollege?
Hallo.
Guck, die anderen heulen auch.
Hallo.
Die anderen heulen auch.
Ja, von der York.
Dala. Timo. Dala, Timo. Ja. Tick, 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 tick. Was ist da? Tick, 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 tick.
Super, das klappt prima. Ja.
Gestern hat sie gelegen und ruht hier so Kopf,
ja,
runter. Das fühlte sich an wie ein Gruß.
Beide haben nicht die Ohrringe. Halt, die Ohrringe.
Stand up. Not the things. Stand up.
Yeah.
You need to stand up. Because these
earrings,
it's dangerous.
This metal. Yeah.
Yeah, you like those.
No.
Don't
think
there.
Not mix.
What?
They are like thieves. Yeah.
yeah, definitely.
Auch ist das Anspringen witzig. Demnächst finden wir es, glaube ich, gar nicht mehr so witzig.
Dann ist es noch größer, noch schwerer.
So, thank you for the day. It's been real wonderful, and thank you for let us come here and make this document. And
yeah, thank you for your visit here in Germany.
Yeah.
It was a long way from Finland to Germany.
Yeah, it's been a wonderful experience
to come
here.
Yes, and I feel happy that you are interested how we handle wolves in Germany, what are problems, what are solutions, and maybe there might be an idea for Finland a little bit, I don't know.
Yeah.
And on the other hand, I'm sure we can learn from Finland.
Yeah.
With respect to wild
boars. Yeah, like what's better. Yeah.
So next time I will visit you.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah, I'm looking forward.
Yes, thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you.
Have a good way back home.
Yeah, thanks.
You're welcome.
Moikka kaikille vaan. Mä oon Sara Veikkolainen täältä Siilinjärveltä. Kohta 19, ei kun siis kohta 20 vuotta. Ja minun viestinä tavallaan tässä koko ja syy periaatteessa, minkä takia mä tähän dokumenttiin lähdin, on se, että ihmiset lukekaa kriittisellä mielellä niitä juttuja. Elikäkä uskoko kaikkea, mitä vaikka lehistö revittelee tai mitä ihmiset kuulo- ja huhupuheena niin kuin levittää eteenpäin. Se, että hankkikaa niitä faktoja ja sen jälkeen vasta niin kuin muodostakaa se oma mielipide siitä. Elikäkä menkö vaan niin kuin massana ja lietsykö sitä hysteriaa lisää.